When the story of Air Tractor began, Leland Snow was already two decades into his aviation career. After the sale and relocation of his first company, Snow Aeronautical Corporation, he was ready for a fresh start and a new design, the AT-300. It's a classic American success story. It began again in Olney, Texas in 1972, with Leland and a handful of others building the tooling, the airplane prototype, and the static test fixtures. 3 days ahead of schedule on September 27, 1973, Leland made the first test flight of the AT-300. Jeff Burke and Mike Wilcox of Rio Hondo, Texas took delivery of the first Air Tractor in March 1974. They liked it so much, they bought many more as their business grew. In 1976, the first AT-302 powered by a Lycoming turbine engine took flight. Leland would later switch to the Pratt & Whitney Canada PT-6, which was lighter, more powerful, and well known for reliability. By October 1977, 100 Air Tractor airplanes had been delivered, followed soon after by the 200th, 300th, and 400th Air Tractors. As Air Tractor entered the 1980s, sales were strong. In 1981, the first PT-6 powered AT-400 was rolled out. 10 of them were sold by the end of the year. Many of these were sold internationally and made transatlantic flights to Egypt, Sweden, and Austria. But by 1983, sales began to slide with the onset of the American farm crisis. It completely altered the fabric of rural America, and Air Tractor wasn't immune. Production slowed, and employees dwindled to about 35 people working a 27-hour week. It was during this slowdown that Leland focused the company on research and development of new airplanes. This continued through the remainder of the 1980s. A prototype AT-503 was built. The two-seat, 500-gallon airplane was designed for the U.S. State Department for use in their narcotic crop eradication program in Colombia. Though the 503 did not win the contract, the experience led Leland to design the AT-502, which would later become Air Tractor's best-selling ag plane. The two-seat cockpit and fuselage design of the AT-503 would also be the basis for development of the tandem-seat AT-802 a few years later. When the economy finally turned around in October 1987, a steady flow of airplane orders followed. They were mostly for the new 500-gallon capacity AT-502. After the farm crisis, Snow was keen to diversify the company beyond ag planes. A big two-seat airplane could fit the bill as a firefighting air tanker, and the AT-802 was the answer. The 802 prototype test flight took place on October 30, 1990. The AT-802 did indeed provide the diversity that Leland wanted as both an air tanker and ag plane. It was the industry's biggest and most productive ag plane, and with so much payload capacity, new applications for the airplane were plentiful. The 1990s was a time of refinement and product improvement. The 502B, 402B, and 401B with longer wingspans and more effective dispersal systems were introduced. The 502A and 602 were also added to the model lineup. This gave Air Tractor the competitive advantage of having an extensive product line with a model to fit every size operation. It was around this time that a new Air Tractor paint scheme began appearing on its turbine engine models. To meet the ever-increasing demand for its airplanes, Air Tractor added an additional 55,000 square foot factory building in 1997. On a bright, crisp day in March 1998, Air Tractor hosted a celebration of Leland Snow's 40th year of airplane production in Olney, Texas. He came to Olney in 1958 with his first aircraft design, and the event was to show appreciation for the town's 40-year investment in Snow's vision. More than 1,600 customers, Air Tractor dealers, vendors, VIPs, and employees enjoyed a perfect spring day together with a barbecue luncheon and an air show. Air Tractor had 120 planes on order that year. The turn of the century brought about new challenges for Air Tractor. A fatal Air Tractor accident involving a wing separation occurred, as Snow and his engineering team had already begun a wing fatigue testing program. The accident brought renewed urgency to the testing program, scrutiny from regulators, and concerns from customers. The Air Tractor team of engineers, customer service, and dealers responded immediately to the problem. A rigorous program of wing inspections, crack prevention, wing safe life, and spar cap replacement was put into action. In addition, during this time, another sales slump hit the agricultural industry, and the company produced only 33 aircraft in 2002. But, like before, Air Tractor pressed on with new opportunities and developed a modified armor-plated version of the AT-802 Ag version for the U.S. Department of State's Program of Narcotic Crop Eradication in Colombia. Flying in hazardous mountainous terrain while taking small arms fire from the ground, these planes and their brave pilots played a vital role in combating the spread of narcotics. Between 2002 and 2015, when the program ended, Air Tractor delivered 18 of these modified 802s for this mission. In the early 2000s, Air Tractor worked with float manufacturer Whip Air to develop the Fire Boss, a water-scooping amphibious version of the 802F. This added another tool to the aerial firefighter's toolbox. As the Fire Boss could take off from an airfield, then scoop water from nearby lakes to attack fires continuously. And perhaps most gratifying for Leland Snow, the 802F had come into its own and was earning much respect for its aerial firefighting capabilities. It became the dominant initial attack single-engine air tanker while fighting fires in the United States, Canada, South America, Europe, and Australia. In 2004, the 2000th Air Tractor, an AT-502B, was delivered, and the following year, the 200th AT-802 was sold. In 2007, the Snow family began making plans to assure the long-term success of the company. Leland felt that Air Tractor employees helped make the company what it is, and the benefit of ownership would drive them to continue to build the business that he loved. So, in July 2008, Air Tractor became employee-owned. The Employee Stock Ownership Plan, or ESOP as it's called, provides a retirement benefit to employees at no cost to them. As the value of the company stock grows, so does the employee benefit. Behind the scenes, Leland kept his engineering and research and development teams busy. They began design work and prototype construction on a 1,000-gallon air tanker, the AT-1002. Snow made the first flight of the aircraft in November 2009. They also introduced the AT-504, a two-seat side-by-side version of the popular AT-502B. It was an ideal trainer for the next generation of ag pilots, and one that also delivers the productivity that operators expect from their air tractor. Never one to sit back and relax, Snow also developed the AT-802U, a military version based on the rugged reliability of the State Department 802. The mission would be counterinsurgency and surveillance, with precision strike capability and dirt strip utility. The 802U made its debut at the Paris Air Show in 2009, where the United Arab Emirates became the launch customer. By the end of the decade, sales exceeded 100 aircraft per year, and more than 50% of those were exports. In February 2011, while on his morning run, Leland Snow passed away. Although his death was unexpected, Leland had trained and developed a capable and experienced management team. Jim Hirsch, then Vice President of Engineering, was appointed as the new President of Air Tractor. With Hirsch at the helm, the company had a record sales year in 2012 of 180 aircraft, including 11 of the AT-802Us delivered to the UAE. 2013 was a fun and positive year for the company and the ag aviation industry, as Air Tractor went Hollywood and partnered with Disney to promote the release of the movie Planes. The animated movie featured an Air Tractor lookalike named Dusty Crophopper. With the help of a Texas operator, a real-life version of Dusty was created and flown in air shows around the country, entertaining kids and grown-ups alike. At the same time, Air Tractor built its 3,000th aircraft, and both airplanes were featured in a prime location at the EAA Air Adventure in Oshkosh. The movie character in the air show provided a wonderful opportunity for the general public to learn more about the importance of ag aviation. But most exciting for Leland's two young grandchildren was attending the Hollywood premiere of Planes, for an unforgettable experience with their parents and grandmother. And almost a decade after the movie release, the real Dusty found a permanent home in the Smithsonian's Udvar Hazy Center. In 2015, Air Tractor introduced the 502 XP, a more powerful version of the popular 500-gallon model. Powered by the modern PT6A-140AG, it has become the choice for operators looking for more productivity, fuel efficiency, and better performance in hot and high conditions. During the latter half of the decade, Air Tractor management focused internally on increasing manufacturing efficiency and capacity. Blazing a trail for the aerospace industry, the company partnered with PPG to develop the first electrocoat primer system in aviation. The E-coat process has many benefits. It improves the quality and efficiency of application. It vastly reduces waste from paint overspray. And because it uses a non-chrome primer, it greatly reduces worker exposure and improves safety. Now, in the current decade, Air Tractor continues to grow our workforce, focus on operational excellence, and expand factory space to meet the historic worldwide demand. Supply chain disruptions have become the norm since 2020, but the purchasing, engineering, production, and management teams continue to successfully navigate every challenge thrown their way. Engineering and R&D work continues on the AT-1002 with a redesigned and new prototype, all the while working with the FAA to develop the certification basis for the world's largest single-engine aircraft. Milestone events such as delivery of the 4,000th Air Tractor and the 1,000th AT-802 have occurred in recent years, with current annual production of around 200 aircraft. Air Tractor is also working with L3Harris to deliver the 802U Skywarden for a contract with the U.S. Special Operations Command. As we look back at the humble beginnings of Air Tractor, we are thankful for Leland Snow's vision and passion for the industry. We reflect on the values he instilled and the culture he created: customer service, continuous product improvement, quality, and pride in workmanship. These are hallmarks of the Air Tractor brand. Together with our loyal employees, dealers, and customers, Air Tractor has helped feed, clothe, and protect people around the world for the last 50 years. And with the same vision and care, we'll continue to do so for decades to come.